We're asked to simplify these square roots using complex numbers. Complex numbers are numbers in the form of a plus bi, where a is the real part, bi is the imaginary part, I equals the square root of negative 1, and I squared equals negative 1. Real numbers are complex numbers when b equals 0 and a does not. Imaginary numbers are complex numbers when a equals 0 and b does not. The first example, we have the square root of 16. More specifically, this is the principal square root of 16. This is equal to the positive number squared that is equal to 16. And because 4 times 4 equals 16, let's write this as the square root of 4 squared. And again, because positive 4 squared equals 16, the square root of 16 is equal to 4. We can always check the result by squaring 4 to make sure we do get the original radicand of 16, which we do. We can also think of the square root as undoing the squaring. I also want to mention 16 actually has two square roots, positive 4 and negative 4. This is a notation we use, the principal square root, when we want the positive square root. If we wanted the negative square root of 16, the notation would be negative square root 16, which would give us negative 4 as the negative square root of 16. Next, we have the square root of 49, which is equal to the positive number squared equal to 49. Because 49 equals 7 times 7, let's write this as the square root of 7 squared. And because positive 7 squared equals 49, the square root of 49 is equal to positive 7. And again, just to check again, 7 squared equals 49, verifying our result. And again, we can also think of the square root as undoing the squaring. Next, we have the square root of negative 16. In this case, there is no real number squared equal to negative 16. This indicates the square root is equal to an imaginary number. To better understand this, because negative 16 is equal to 16 times negative 1, let's write the square root of negative 16 as the square root of 16 times negative 1, which we can write as a product. We can write this as the square root of 16 times the square root of negative 1. We know from above the square root of 16 is equal to 4, and by definition, the square root of negative 1 is equal to I. The square root of negative 16 is equal to 4i. Again, let's check this. This indicates if we square 4i, we should get negative 16. So the square of 4i is equal to 16i squared, but I squared is equal to negative 1, and 16 times negative 1 is equal to negative 16. For our last example, we have the square root of negative 49. Again, there is no real number squared equal to negative 49, indicating the result will be imaginary. Let's write the square root of negative 49 as the square root of 49 times negative 1, which we can write as the square root of 49 times the square root of negative 1. We know from above the square root of 49 is 7, the square root of negative 1 is I, indicating the square root of negative 49 is equal to 7i. And again, let's go ahead and check this. The square of 7i must be equal to negative 49. The square of 7i is equal to 49i squared. I squared equals negative 1, giving us 49 times negative 1, which is negative 49. I hope you found this helpful.